women's rights activist from Denton. She's a member of the Radical Alliance for Gender Equality and the International Socialist Organization. And let's give it up for Natalie Johnson. Yay!
Like 5 minutes, but before I get started, I just wanted to pass around these flyers. The Radical Alliance for Gender Equality, a group that we started in Denton, we just made this Tumblr called We Are the One in Three, and it's asking women, or those who maybe don't identify as women but who have had abortions, to post their stories and to, in order to take the stigma off of abortion, to show that it's just a routine medical procedure. So if any of you guys, I'll pass these around if any of you guys want to take one. All right. So we're here protesting the bankers and their friends on Wall Street because they have been gambling and betting with our lives. Big banks, their corporate allies, and the government that works in their interests instead of ours have systematically targeted poor, working class women in their commitment to gutting unions, ripping away any sort of social safety net, denying us access to quality health care, and criminalizing our bodies by stripping us of our autonomy in the form of personhood amendments, slut shaming, and state-sanctioned rape in the form of mandated vaginal sonograms if a woman wants an abortion. Since the economic collapse in 2008, we've heard that there has been an economic recovery. But we have to ask, recovery for who? ThinkProgress.org quotes that big banks paid 5,000 bonuses of at least $1 million in 2008. According to the New York Attorney General's office, 9 of the financial firms that were among the largest recipients of federal bailout money paid about 5,000 of their traders and bankers bonuses of more than $1 million apiece for 2008. And for what? What do these traders and bankers do that deserve such a lavish bonus? Bet and gamble on who is more likely to default on their mortgage payments. And in a sexist, racist society, is it any surprise that women are 32% more likely than men to receive subprime mortgages? And Latina and African American women borrowers are most likely to receive subprime loans at every income level. Bank profits are higher now than before 2008. Where is this profit coming from? It seems contradictory to the experiences that millions of working people are facing, such as layoffs, cuts to pay and benefits, and an overall loss of job security, student debt that enslaves us in an economy with no decent jobs, imperialist wars abroad, and austerity at home. Oppressive legislative and cultural attacks on immigrants, women, sexual and racial minorities, and the poor. The 1% profits by the billions while the rest of us are fighting to put food on the table, afford an education, adequate health care, and a safe environment to work and live in as conditions are getting worse and worse. So when faced with this contradiction, I ask again, where is the profit coming from? It's being stolen from the labor of the workers who produce the wealth in society. Women make up 51% of the world's population, but 70% of the world's poor. They perform 66% of the world's work, produce 50% of the food, but earn 10% of the income and own less than 1% of the world's property. Under this current system, employers pay workers a wage, but take no responsibility for most of the social cost of maintaining the current generation of workers, or for raising the next generation of workers into adulthood. Rather than these responsibilities being shared collectively by society as a whole through government programs, paid for by taxing the profits of the private enterprises that employ workers, they are shouldered by individual families. And within the family, it is primarily women who are expected to perform the unpaid domestic labor of raising children, cooking, housework, and primary health care. In 1995, the UN Development Program reported that women's unpaid and underpaid labor annually represented $11 trillion worldwide and $1.4 trillion in the United States alone. And Maddie told me a recent statistic in 2009 was the total worldwide was $13 trillion. Bankers and other one percenters whose economic and political interests are vastly different from the rest of society use the government as a tool to keep the system that benefits them at the expense of the rest of us in place. Most of the government officials are a part of the 1% themselves. One must have millions of dollars to even consider running for president, or thousands for even a local campaign. We have to make the connections between the corrupt bankers, Wall Street traders, corporate bosses, and the state that protects their interests with legislation and the force of the military. We are living in serious times where our right to protest the government is being challenged through legislation right now. H.R. 347, a bill that U.S. President Barack Obama signed his name to on Thursday, officially makes it a federal offense to cause a disturbance at certain political events, essentially criminalizing protest in the states. It is is so important that we are all out here showing that we are going to fight against oppression and exploitation and show the world that we know who the enemies are. They own the bank. They own our schools, our workplaces, our homes. They own the water we drink, the minerals in the ground we walk on, and even the genetic codes to certain strains of plants and food. It's time we unite in solidarity with one another and organize a movement that can lead us to victory in our fight for human liberation and an end to all oppression. A democratic, grassroots movement that can transform society from a system based on profit for the few at the expense of the many to a system where decisions about the organization of society are made democratically with the aim of meeting all human needs. I look forward to every moment of the struggle that we encounter together. Get involved with organizations. Code PINK is a great one. And thanks.
Hey. Yeah. Hey.